Hi, everybody. This is Crystal Proxmire of Oakland County Times. We're here today with Eagle Harbor Mayor Brian Lumpel, who's running for re-election to the City Council. How are you today?
I'm very well, thank you. Happy to be here. And yourself?
Great. Well, thank you for doing this. Can you tell us, how long have you been on the council for?
Sure. I've been on City Council going on 3 years. I was elected in November of 2018. In my second year, I served as mayor pro tem, and now I'm the mayor of Keego Harbor, which has truly been my honor and my privilege to serve the community in this capacity.
So what are some of the things that you're most proud of in the time that you've been on council?
Sure. Well, I think there's several things that we accomplished over the past few years since I've been elected that I'm proud of. But to name a few, I think how we handled the pandemic and were able to help our local businesses was extremely important. This past year and a half has been very difficult with the pandemic, and it certainly impacted Keego Harbor, our residents and businesses significantly. So I was able to assist in putting a city preparedness and response plan in effect quickly. We were able to work with city staff and my fellow council members to find ways to try and mitigate the economic effects. And we have many great restaurants in Keego Harbor. And to help those businesses, I worked with council to pass an ordinance to expand the outdoor dining areas so they could create larger dining areas to maintain adequate social distancing. The other thing that I was heavily involved with was being able to obtain a couple of different grants from the federal government and Oakland County to assist our bars and our restaurants through this period, as well as we were able to utilize funds to offset COVID-related expenses to help keep our employees and our residents safe while conducting business within our city building. But the real bright spot in an otherwise difficult year was seeing so many of the people in our community come together to help one another. And I was very proud to be able to be a part of those efforts. One of the other things that I did when I was elected to council was I spearheaded the effort to redo our website to make it more engaging for our residents and visitors. Community engagement and involvement is very important. And this website was the first part in facilitating that. We have robust notifications and alert systems so we can keep our community better informed. And I'm happy to report that it's been very well received. Though I'd have to say one of the most exciting projects I've been able to be involved with and help facilitate, and certainly has been the work that I've been able to do with the TIFA board and the TIFA district master plan, what we refer to as our village plan for Keego Harbor. It's taken about a year and a half to complete. I'm sorry, it's taken about a year to complete and was the combined efforts of many people, including the TIFA board, the planning commission, the city council, and a lot of community engagement. It's an exciting and ambitious but doable plan. It reimagines the Cass Lake Road corridor into a more walkable area, complete with additional shops, cafes, integrated green spaces. And I'm really looking forward to continuing working in the rest of the community.
What are some of the things that you'd like to work on if you're reelected?
Certainly. So some of the things that I'm looking forward to doing are we've reinitiated our road preservation program. We had to pause that program the last year due to the pandemic, but we're slated to resume it in the spring, and I will see that through. And I will also be seeking additional grants so that we can do more to fix our aging infrastructure. Another priority is finding more ways to engage with our existing businesses and business owners in order to help further support them. And as council liaison for the TIFA board, I'm looking forward to continuing my work with them, with the TIFA board, to complete the many exciting projects that are underway. We're redoing our light poles, repainting them, putting new bases on them. And as I mentioned, we finished the TIFA district master plan, but we're just really beginning to commence the real hard work, which is putting it into action. So there are many things we must do to make that plan a reality, and I'm committed to seeing that materialize for our residents and community.
So what are some of the ways that you've been involved in the community?
Sure. Well, prior to being on City Council, I served on the Planning Commission. I was the chairman of the Zoning Board of Appeals. And in the past, I've volunteered to help out with our city events. I like to say I have two full-time jobs that I enjoy immensely. When I'm not working at my business, most of my other time is dedicated to Keego Harbor. As mayor, I participate in many webinars and meetings and roundtable discussions with various agencies, with the county and at the state level, always assessing and looking out for opportunities that will help the city and matters that should come to council for more consideration, policy discussion, and so forth.
So can you tell us a bit more about your professional experience and what skills you bring to the table?
Sure. So I am by profession, I am an investment banker and business advisor. What that means from a practical standpoint is I assist businesses in raising capital. I help them assess and evaluate their businesses, refine their business models, and assist them with improving their business operations. Prior to being an investment banker, I was an executive for several companies. I worked in retail, media, and entertainment, software development industries. Overall, I have a strong business and finance background and inherent analytical and problem-solving abilities. On the education side, I hold a Bachelor of Science in Management with a major in Entrepreneurial Studies and a concentration in Management Information Systems from Babson College. I have the Citizen Planner credential from Michigan State University. It's a program that's geared towards municipal zoning and planning, which obviously is extremely helpful in the work I do on behalf of the city. I have some public safety experience. I'm a former auxiliary police officer. And 2 years ago, I had the opportunity to take part in the Oakway Fire Ops training program through West Bloomfield Fire Department, which is a one-day program to experience a day in the life of an EMS and firefighter, which truly gave me a deeper appreciation for everything these brave men and women do for us every day. As you can see, I have a wide range of practical experience and education to draw from.
So in this race, there are a few people running for these positions. Why should the voters reelect you?
Certainly. Well, as you've heard previously, I have experience, I have background and skills to continue to do a great job on city council and on behalf of our city. Most importantly, though, I truly love Keego Harbor and care deeply about our city. Our residents should know that I'm committed and dedicated to serving our community and continuing to make Keego Harbor a great place to live, work, and visit.
So if those residents want more information about you and your campaign, where can they go?
Sure. Well, I'm very accessible. If voters want more information, they can visit my website, brianlample.com. There's a lot of information about me and ways to contact me. They can also email me directly at brian@gokeego.com. That's gokeego.com. I also walk the city regularly with my wife, and our residents should feel free to stop me to talk. I really enjoy engaging with our residents, and I always welcome the opportunity to talk with them.
Perfect. Well, thank you for doing the interview with us today.
Thank you, Crystal. I really appreciate you taking the time today.